Welcome back to Madison's Mayor Minute. So he's going to give us a little update. This is Bob Courtney, the Madison's mayor, and he's got some cool things going on. What is one of the neatest things about your team building that you've been doing?
Well, we're putting together a fantastic team,
a
leadership team that is all designed to help us achieve our key initiatives that we campaign on. We're going to deliver results to the community, and to have the right people in the right place is important to do that.
And some of that comes with safety with the Madison, you know, the city of Madison. You've got the safety that you're going to look at.
Community safety is the number one thing for my job, my role, and commitment as mayor. So make sure that we have the right leadership at and the resources at the Madison Police Department is important, because safety is not only just about the law enforcement side of things, right, but it's also about sidewalks, streets, lighting, parks, all types of things roll into community safety.
Oh, wow. Well, I know you've been really busy. I come in your office and you, it looks like a beehive in there.
It is. There's a lot of excitement going on. We are very busy, but it's exciting to start planning these things that we've been talking about for a year.
Oh, yeah.
And you know, our goal in this administration is to really be transformative. Certainly provide cost-effective basic needs that the community wants, but to put us on the next level with regards to quality of life initiatives, community safety, and to do things from an economic development perspective that really make a difference.
And then with the infrastructure, that's part of what you're doing. You actually have plans for your infrastructure going forward.
Infrastructure is very important. There were already quite a few projects underway underneath the stellar designation that we achieved a couple of years ago. So over the course of the next 2 years, those projects will actually come into fruition. We've been doing the designing and financial planning for those now. And there's going to be some big projects, particularly downtown here, as well as on the hilltop.
Oh, wow. I can't wait to see what happens with all that.
It's going to be great.
I think so. Now, with economic development, I love this. I know you're going to move somebody over into your building so that you have better access to them. So what are some of the things you're doing with economic development?
Well, what I mentioned earlier, Debbie, about putting the right leadership team in place, we allowed the contract with JCIDC to expire at the end of the year, and that was a very intentional move, and we worked very closely with JCIDC executives as well as their full board to put this into place. But all along, the goal was to streamline economic development and also make it more synergistic and effective with the apparatus that's already in place for the city. And that involved moving Matt Worth, who is our lead economic developer at JCIDC, to the city of Madison to work on key city initiatives, and then furthering preparing goals and objectives for the Redevelopment Commission, the Economic Development Commission, reprioritizing the work of Nicole Schell with our city planner, hiring resources to fill in on the preservation planning side of things, but also gives us both the city of Madison and JCIDC an opportunity to reevaluate our respective roles. And I'm really, really excited with the way JCIDC has embraced these changes, but also with the role that they're going to have in the future, which is going to be more strategic, out there taking advantage of the resources regionally as well as countywide, and doing things that will benefit our community in a much broader scale by working more synergistically as well with the city of Madison's economic development team.
I think it's wonderful, because if you've got Matt right there beside you, when you have somebody come into your office to meet, you can just say, hey, Matt, come over, come around. Come next door. Come into my office.
Yeah, and the whole
makes it easier.
The whole intention here is to realign.
Yes.
Realign the resources so that, you know, we have everybody working together, and their goal is to achieve these key initiatives relative to our economic development priorities. But then again, you know, the role that JCIDC is going to play, both of our respective roles are going to be effective, but done in a very less traditional way than it's been done in Jefferson County in the past.
I think it'll still be effective. It'll have more of a streamline.
It will be effective, and it will also allow us to partner more effectively as well with Jefferson County and the right. Jefferson County Commissioner. So we've been having some very good dialogue with them on ways we can partner mm-hmm. that we've never done before.
Oh, I think anything outside of the box is always worth looking at.
I agree.
So that's wonderful. Now, you did something just recently. You got to go to the State of the State, and I noticed that Madison was very well represented at State of the State.
Well, as you know, last week Governor Holcomb gave his State of the State address.
Yes.
He's done a very good job in his first 3 years as governor. Certainly, this is his reelection year. And this was his fourth delivery, I believe, of the State of the State. And Madison was very well represented, as well as used as an example across the state for what our local industry leaders are doing for workforce development and partnering with the Department of Corrections to make sure that there's a career path
yes.
for individuals who have been in the Department of Corrections for the last several years to come out with a skill so that they can make a contribution to the communities that they're living in. And I'm really grateful for several of our industries who have
yes.
embraced that, and they're creating not only skilled workers but opportunity. They're eliminating barriers, and that's something that we're also all about as well, eliminating barriers and creating opportunity.
I think that it takes a lot for a business owner to take that step, because you have to really work with that person that comes out and train them and help them get through
sure.
their things. So that is a big thing to take on.
And the thing that I would just emphasize there, and it's something that my administration stands for too, it's to dedicate the resources that are necessary
yes.
to have intentional outcomes.
Mm-hmm.
And in order to have intentional outcomes, whether it be to create job opportunities, deepen your workforce mm-hmm. development, fill a need that you might have with regard to your skilled workforce, raise wages, for example, all of that has to be done through a thoughtful process
yes.
so you can have an intentional outcome. Very, very little that I consider success happens by accident. So I'm grateful for, Dominic Grody, for example, at Grody
right.
Industries, who was featured in Governor Holcomb's State of the State address, as well as our other industry leaders who
right.
I know are also partnering with Ivy Tech and the Department of Corrections
yes.
to create opportunity and eliminate barriers.
And those are positive opportunities. It's a positive outcome. It's a positive opportunity. So I think it's going to be well embraced.
I would use an even bolder word than positive. It's transformational.
Yes.
Transformational
yes.
for the lives who are being literally changed
yes.
by having an opportunity. And some of the individuals in these programs, probably have not had a lot of opportunity throughout the course of their lives. And I just think it's fantastic that
yes.
that our leaders in our community are approaching a need like this.
I think it's great. It speaks a lot about our community.
It really does.
It really does. Now, you had a chance to go somewhere just recently. Where did you get to go last week?
I was so blessed and honored to be invited by the president to go to the White House and attend the signing ceremony of the U.S.-China trade agreement. And it was a fascinating experience. I got to meet a lot of industry people across the United States, particularly those in the agricultural industry who are going to benefit tremendously by this first phase
yes.
of the U.S.-China agreement. And it's just one example, in my opinion, of what our president is doing for trade with other countries that benefit the United States.
Well, that's wonderful. Now, is there anything we need to tell everybody before we let them go?
Well, I mean, as it relates to that, the other thing that I did while I was in Washington,
yes.
D.C., was I had an opportunity to meet with both of our senators,
yes.
Senator Braun and Senator Young, as well as our 6th District Congressman, Greg Pence.
Yes.
And the goal there was to, A, let them know what we're doing with regards to applying for federal funding.
Right.
They're all very interested in helping our community, but also to keep Madison on their radar. We're going to be in front of them more frequently over the course of the next 4 years, asking for their support. And we need federal dollars in particular for our infrastructure,
mm-hmm.
whether it be Main Street, Clifty Drive,
right.
our airport, our Port Authority, our riverfront. There's just a lot of key initiatives that we're going to be embarking on over the course of the next, really the next 12 to 18 months, and I'm very excited about. And so at the end of the day, this is all about cultivating relationships
yes.
and getting to know them and making sure that they know Madison is here. We're a thriving, prosperous, growing community, And we have some great things on the horizon for the city of Madison.
I think so. And if you don't talk to these people, they don't think you need anything. So you have to keep that relationship up to where they actually know what's going on.
And what I find is that they're very accessible and they want to help.
They are.
And they want to help. But there's also an educational opportunity here to share with them the good things that we're doing in Madison and also what we're planning to do. So that we can, again, have these intentional outcomes. And a lot of these big infrastructure projects that we're talking about have long lead times. And, you know, we've got to do the consensus building. We have to really drill down and be able to explain the project really well. We've got to get the funding for it and the designing for it. And then, of course, the implementation stage. So, you know, we're talking about some initiatives that are going to take 2 or 3 years to obtain. But we've also got shorter term goals that when you add them up, it's going to be transformational. And that's what we want to do. We want to make sure that the quality of life in Madison is above and beyond what it's ever been before. And we're going to be focusing a lot on neighborhood revitalization, clean, safe, beautiful neighborhoods make a strong and healthier and more vibrant community, and that's what we're going to all be about.
Well, we have one more thing to cover, and that is today you managed to appoint someone as an interim for the chief of police.
Yeah, so, you know, community safety has been very important to me, and it's my number one priority. Without a safe community, we can't achieve the economic development goals and the quality of life initiatives that we want to have. I announced probably about a month ago, right after the election, that we would embark on an independent recruitment process for a chief of police, and we received 65 applicants for that
amazing
position, which I think is great. Also, it's a testimony of the type of community that we have and people that from all over the country that would want to relocate here to share with us their skill set to move our community forward. But I did appoint Ben McKay as our interim police chief yesterday. Ben is a 15-year veteran with the Madison Police Department. He's been the commander of our countywide SWAT group for about a decade now. He and I have had a very good working relationship in the few months that I've been in the mayor's office now, and he's committed to working with us to achieve our key initiatives. And one of those key initiatives is safe community, and that's a very broad initiative. It's not just one particular item, but it's a lot of different things. And I'm looking forward to working with Chief McKay, and particularly completing this recruitment process over the course of the next six to eight weeks.
So we have to look forward to that in about 6 or 8 weeks. So that's good.
That will be. We'll be rounding out our leadership team by then.
Right.
We still have a few other positions to fill, such as a preservation planner, an outreach coordinator, some administration help, and then we're working through that process now with our city council leadership.
Oh, wow. Well, thanks for coming in today. You've shared a lot of knowledge today.
We've got a lot going on. It is exciting. We are still also looking for volunteers on many of the boards and committees that we have. So if people are interested in getting involved, please reach out to the mayor's office. And we're also doing the best that we can to update our website, make sure our calendar is updated so people know when our meetings are. We're doing a lot of press releases so that we can be transparent. So people can see what's going on, and we're just modernizing things so it can be just more effective, and we want people to be involved in their government.
Well, you heard Bob Courtney. You need to call the mayor's office and ask them what's available, what's out there, and what you can help with. So try to do that. And as always, we appreciate our sponsors, and we thank Bob for coming in today for Mayor's Minute.
Thank you, Debbie.
And as always, we thank you for watching.